welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today's video is all about hair and curls, and you know, this is the exciting video, the video that was so highly requested. When I posted a selfie of my curls on Instagram, you guys went crazy. So I'm here to share with you what I learned from Kozma and Kozma, which is a curl specialist salon in Dubai that my friend Xiia was so nice enough to take me to and treat me to. So I feel like it's my duty to share with you guys some of the knowledge, the curl knowledge that I learned. To be honest, I tried it like yesterday. It didn't work. It really didn't work out for me because I was so impatient and I didn't do it properly, because I thought maybe like I'll do it at home and then film a video like that. But you know what, it's fine. Let me just leave it to the professionals and I'll show you actual footage from the salon in Dubai. I'm gonna try it again when I have more time and when I don't forget like my brush in my room. Like for example, when I went to the shower and dried out yesterday, I forgot that I needed a comb or like a brush to brush through my hair. I forgot that I needed like a specific conditioner. Like I just forgot it all. So when I tried it, it didn't work, and that's my own fault. So anyway, I'm rambling on. Let me just show you what I learned. So let's go with me to Dubai.
Second last day in Dubai, and we're going for like, I'm going for a hair treatment. My friend Xiia, she hooked girl up and she's getting Koyen and Katie some foot spa kind of a treatment, and I'm getting my hair done. So specifically for curls, that's what she told me. So I'm really excited to see.
All the way through, you know, around the hairline, on the scalp, everywhere. Because you still want to moisturize up here, you know, near the scalp area, because that's where you do find that a lot of frizz comes. Just gonna get a tumble tweezer. Have you seen one of these brushes before?
Yeah.
Yeah? So it's important to always comb your conditioner through. Every time you put conditioner in, you want to comb it through, because you're gonna need to get rid of any sort of tangles in there to help prevent any breakage. It's gonna distribute this conditioner all the way through, and it's just gonna help give you a much more smoother finish. Okay, so it's important to detangle every time.
So you do this when you apply the moisturizing conditioner?
Yeah, you put your conditioner in and then detangle. Okay. So it's much easier to sort of comb through when you've got your conditioner in. And it's not going to pull the hair as much. You know, so you don't want to be like pulling it to cause breakage or anything. It's just sort of gliding through more when the conditioner's in. Okay. Skin's detangled. So you'd be, you know, comb everything through with the conditioner with the tangle teaser. So we don't want to leave like a very thick white conditioner on like this. We want it to be more watered down because we're obviously leaving it in the hair. So while you're still in the shower, put your shower on like a low pressure, and we're just going to rinse a little bit from the scalp area. Okay, so then what that's going to do is create like a really nice watered down conditioner, which we're going to leave in the hair. Alright, so just like a low pressure, just gonna literally give it like a little rinse on the scalp, just to take away that really thick white layer. But everything else is left in, so we're not gonna fully completely rinse all this out. Like a lot of this conditioner is gonna be left in the hair. That's where we get like our moisture from. Okay, so when you're doing this at home, you can then tip your head upside down, so everything's gonna be falling forward. Yeah, so it's just gonna be a lot easier to work with. I'm just going to work in small sections. I'm just going to comb through. So use your fingers and just literally comb through each section. So see all this kind of hair that's gathered together? We want to really smooth that out. Okay, so you're just literally working with your fingers, just using them as a comb, just to really sort of comb everything through. Okay, so can you see now how everything starts to like group together?
Mm-hmm.
So this is what we're looking for. So we want that nice sort of definition to come through. Yeah, so like this.
Okay.
So each section you're gonna work with. So obviously it's all like sort of still a bit tangled up through this root here. You wanna get in right at that root area and just really work it through with your fingers. Okay, so you're kind of like pulling out the frizz from the root and making it a lot smoother. Obviously this watered down conditioner is still in the hair, so that's going to help hydrate everything, and then your fingers are going to really sort of detangle it up.
So is this a specific conditioner that you use? Like,
this is just like a nice moisturizing conditioner.
Okay.
But yeah, as long as it's like a super moisturizing conditioner, you can use. Okay. So you're literally gonna do this all the way through. So I'm keeping everything very wet while I'm doing this. The reason for that is when the hair is wet, the cuticle is wide open. So all this product and everything is being absorbed into the hair. So while you're doing it, you want to keep the hair very wet. Otherwise, if it starts to dry off, you're going to end up getting like the cuticle starts to close and the product then just sits on the surface of the hair, you know, and we want it to sit inside. Mm. So it's important to keep the hair very wet.
So I guess my next question is going to be, do you want it to be as defined as possible?
It's gonna be so different. It's gonna be so nice.
I'm so excited.
If you come across a section that still feels a little bit dry on the ends, maybe probably more on yours is this top layer, then just add a little bit more conditioner to your fingers and just work it through the ends back to the top. Okay, so you want everything to feel like very wet, very slimy, you know, and very hydrated. So if you just kind of, if you've got a free hand, if you want to just feel that.
Oh wow.
You know, so it's quite slimy, yeah?
Yeah.
So that's how you know that you've got like enough sort of conditioner and stuff in there. That's how you want it to feel like. A bit like seaweed.
Yeah.
Rub this together through your hands so you've got like a nice even spread. And then from the bottom we're going to scrunch this in. Right up into the root. So from this point now, it's important that we don't break this curl up by running our hands through it or brushing it or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
So literally just going to scrunch from this point. So just from the bottom then, we're just going to scrunch up. Just being gentle, not to break it up or rub it or, you know, be too rough with it. Just literally scrunch in from this point. So that's just going to take away anything that the hair's not absorbed. And it'll speed up your drying time a little bit as well. So. And then we can use the diffuser at the end to sort of give it a little bit more volume. Okay?
Salon is so nice, like they offered me drinks and candies. Oh, I'm having the best time. Xiia really did the things today for me. Wow. I'm gonna try this at home. Like I need to get on this. I need to.
Nourished it long. Okay, so guys, that's basically the little bit of tips and tricks that I learned from Kozma and Kozma Salon. Obviously, when it comes to curls, everyone's curls are different. Everyone's curls kind of react differently. Some of us have tighter curls, some of us have looser curls. You might want curls that are tighter, but your hair pattern, your hair curl is not meant for that. So you guys just need to bear that in mind. Also, if your hair has been damaged, it will take a bit of time in order to get to a healthy kind of a state. Like my curls, I don't know if you guys realize, but if you look like on some of my older pictures, like my curls do not even look like this, because I've been like giving it lots of maintenance these last couple of weeks. I've been just doing a lot. I haven't been styling it. I've just tried to like give my hair some moisture, because curls need moisture. So yeah, do be patient with yourself and your hair. And if you don't succeed in attempting these tips well, or don't do it right the first time, just try it again. There's so many other more tips that I have for curly hair and things, but you guys will see some of that on All Things Hair and on their channel coming soon. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you have some miraculous curl miracles that you know. Leave it in the comments below, and also please don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you guys next time. Bye. It's crazy, yeah.